Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create a Batman logo with godrays background using JavaScript and 3.js in just a few minutes. Let's check it out. In previous tutorial, we have shown you how to import 3D car model into the web page using 3.js. This tutorial is going to reuse that code to import the Batman logo model. You can check out the link to the video in the description box. Next, I'm going to find a suitable model for a bat logo. After some search, I found a free version on Sketchfab, so let's download it. Now here's the code from previous tutorial. Let's replace the car model with the Batman logo and change the model scaling size. And next, let's change the scene background to black and change the camera position and angle. I will also increase the FOV angle and viewing range of the camera. Next, we are going to adjust the light source. We already have multiple light sources from previous tutorial. Now we only need just one directional light from background. I will set the light color to warm yellow and reduce the intensity. Also change the direction to make the glowing background. Now to create a volumetric light or god rays, we need to create a shape of the light source. Let's create a circle shape. The color of the god rays effect is determined by the color of the light source material. I'm going to set that to warm yellow. I'll place it some distance behind the bat logo. Also add a small horizontal scale to create an ellipse shape. Okay, the setup is ready. The next step is to add a godrays post-processing effect to the shape we have just created. There is a nice post-processing library for 3.js that will do the heavy lifting for you. Just download the latest release from GitHub or use npm install command, it's up to you. Once downloaded, copy the post-processing.js and include it to your page using script tag. Next, create an effect object using godrays effect constructor. We'll pass the camera and our circle shape, and next the option object. Here we can customize the godrays characteristic. First is resolution scale, which controls the light resolution. I'll set it to 1. Next is the density of the light, set it to 0.6. Decay is how fast your light will fade, set it to 0.95. Weight is light ray weight factor, set it to 0.9. And the final one is number of light samples per pixel, set it to 100. There is no actual formula for these numbers. It depends on how you want your light to be. Try out the official demo of the library to understand more about each property. Alright, the effect object is ready. Next step is to create the pass. Pass is how we utilize the shader with the post-processing. The first pass we need is a render pass. Normally, we'll use our WebGL render to render the scene, but as we want to apply the post-processing, we'll have to use render pass instead. Next is effect pass. This is where you'll pass the godrays effect object that we created. You can add more than one effect to the pass. We also need to set the render to screen property to true to enable it. The final step is to create an effect composer. This is where you add all your passes to it. You need to pass your normal renderer to the constructor. then use add pass to add all your passes. Then render the scene with composer instead. That looks good, but if you look closely, you'll see jagged edge. You can fix this problem by adding anti-aliasing effect using SMAA pass provided in this library. And here's the final result. You can find the code of this tutorial on our website in the description box below. And that's all for this video, hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to subscribe our channel if you love to see more. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye.